Bill, thanks. We're in the kitchen this morning, and we're sharing recipes from some of the most famous restaurants ever in Columbus.
We certainly are. Doug Moats is the co-author of The Lost Restaurants of Columbus. And I have to tell you, Doug, because we've been talking about the fact that we're going to be giving away one of your books, and I think at 5 o'clock this morning, people are already starting to call.
Oh, yeah. they want a copy.
Well, we appreciate it. Thank you for having me on here. But today we're going to make pepper steak from the Claremont, which is one of Columbus's legendary steakhouses. It started in 1948 by Frank Condos. Actually, 1938, we found out through all of it. But it's cooking a little bit. If you add about two teaspoons of oil.
Two teaspoons of oil.
Brooks, if you go ahead, go ahead and pour that in. If you'll start cutting up the pepper, it takes about a half pepper, but I use a full one. Be careful there. Step back.
I know.
We've got a situation. We got you. We're gonna make this work. So I've got this great iron skillet, right? So we're gonna do that.
And as you saw, we've already had this heated. So you heat this up.
Pour
the oil in.
And then I've got a little bit of salt that I'm gonna cut up and kind of sprinkle over the steak, and my hands are washed.
Okay. Now, do you leave that on the steak for a little while? Because sometimes I've heard that helps, open up the meat a little.
Sure, I've heard that too. In fact, when we were talking with Shelley Bishop about Reeb's restaurant, Reeb's was another one of those great restaurants that people know from the East Side. They would actually cure the beef in a second kitchen for 5 days to make their sauerbraten.
Oh.
So yeah, there are a lot of people that will do that. So I've got some crushed up peppercorns that we've already done. I'm gonna put this on this plate too. We're gonna roll this guy around in those on each side, right? We're gonna make that.
And while Brooks is still cutting up the peppers, you brought a lot of items and some things to share about what is in the book. And it's so fascinating that there are several restaurants that actually have closed,
There's a lot of restaurants that have closed. In fact, one of the oldest ones, or at least the longest lived, was Forster's Restaurant, which is where kind of De Novo is right now.
Mm-hmm.
That was actually around, my co-author Christine found out, for about 120 years. We have some Marzetti's information over here, too, and that was from 1896 to about 1972. Everybody knows it for their dressings, but it was actually a really lavish place to go and dine downtown. And they got to be known for their salad dressings from this lady, an African-American lady, Catherine Hill. She had come up, she was covering in the kitchen. Carl Shoffley said, hey, I need you to come up with a dressing. She did, and that kind of launched a lot of business for Marzetti's.
Well, there you go.
But here's Claremont. We're going to leave that sear on each side for a little bit, and then I've got something here to turn it with. Maybe I'll use your... I'm going to turn it with this, but, you would get it cooking for a while.
We get creative here on Good Day Columbus.
There you go. We absolutely do.
We're going to turn that guy over, and you're going to see it's going to get a nice cut on it.
And so it generally takes about how long?
Oh, this thing, I do about 2 or 3 minutes on each side of this guy. We actually cooked it last night. It's delicious.
All right, you're just searing it, basically.
Yeah, you're searing it. And then we would take it out. In fact, that's what we'll probably do just for fun. We'll take it out. We'll pretend that it actually has cooked all the way, and we'll cook it back later.
Well, the magic of TV and Brooks.
You're going to add half cup or full cup of beef stock.
Oh, sorry.
We're going to cook up the peppers.
Oh, that's right. Half cup of this?
Full cup. Pour it in. This is beef stock.
I tried.
The whole thing.
The whole thing. This is the great stuff. This is about between a half cup and 3/4 cups of brandy.
Oh, there you go.
So,
secret ingredient right here.
I can do that.
Brooks, you can pour whatever you've got of the chopped up pepper in. That'll be fine.
Okay.
Put that in there. You let it bubble. We're going to add just a little bit, Maria, if you would, of the mustard.
The mustard.
Right there, there's that little
there.
Guy. Yep. Just a little pinch or two of that, and we would sear that up. Yep. Perfect.
Okay. Saute it up.
Let it go, and it's going to actually turn out.
There you go, like that. And the magic of TV, as I was mentioning, Brooks, this is the best part.
I'm looking forward to this. And a little bit for you. Well, that's the great thing about the book is there are so many of these places. People would go to restaurants to celebrate, to get engaged, to celebrate birthdays, weddings. And I think so many people have such fond memories of places like the High Lie, Reeb's Restaurant, even local chains, Cantina Del Rio. We go all the way from Marzetti's up to Betty's. So, we cover things from 1896 up to 2014.
What got you interested in this?
Well, we had written a book about the Kahiki. In fact, when Adam was here, Adam and Maria and I had date night at the Kahiki. We got from the steakhouse. We were cooking up Polynesian drinks from the Kahiki. So our editor really loved the way that the Kahiki book came out, asked if we would tackle a whole book about the High Line, which was a fantastic restaurant. Of course, Woody Hayes would always hold his press conferences and things there. And we said, the High Line's great, but maybe another book about all kinds of other restaurants. And I'm tickled that people are calling as early as 5 a.m.
Thanks for sharing this
to get their hands on this. So.
Well, time now for that Good Day giveaway. Yeah. All you have to do is be caller number 8 to win a copy of Lost Restaurants. That number is right there on your screen, 614-821-9883. Again, 614-821-9883. Good luck. And, of course, we have put the recipe as well on our website. Thank you.
Thanks for coming.
And yeah, it's delicious.
And let us know there's going to be a book launch on Monday, December 14th at Acorn Books in Grandview.
There you go.
People want to know where to find it.
Fantastic.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's good. Maybe we'll cook this up a little bit more.
Ooh, I want to
of tax dollars spent to put 1 million electric cars on the road. But when you see what real